My name is Jens Klein, and let's talk today about authentication and authorization in Plume. First, I want to look at the terms. Authentication is about who I am, or who is a client that is talking to my server. It's about identity. So, we know who is talking to us. This is usually done using username and password, and on every single request, the identity is important because the system is stateless. So once logged in with username and password, usually have a token or an authentication cookie that is telling the server who is talking to him. After the identity is known, Plume creates a user object. The user object lives for just one request. And the user object is the important part here because having the user object or having no user object, which is in fact an anonymous user, is important for the system to allow or disallow certain tasks. Then we come to the next part on the other side, that are the permissions. We have many permissions, and permissions are things like view, edit, or publish, or manage the portal, something like that. And we have hundreds of permissions in Plume and Zope, but we don't need all of them in our everyday work. And to make it easier, we never use permissions while assigning them to users. We bundle them in roles. And roles are then much simpler to deal with because a role is like it's an editor, it's a contributor, it's a site administrator, and or it's a reviewer. So the bundled permissions are called roles. The permissions themselves are used in views or to protect your methods in your code, but you don't expose them to the user using Plume. That are the roles. So we have users and roles. We can assign a role to a user on a global level, so in the whole portal, the role is assigned to the user. In all folders, subfolders, everywhere, or we have local roles that are assigned for just one document, like a page or a news item, or for a folder that contains several other content objects. And then the role is assigned for the folder and everything contained there. Next thing to organize our users and roles are groups. Groups are just a bunch of users, and if I assign a role to the group, the user in the group also gets this role. This all happens directly after the request starts, and then all the authentication and assignment of all the roles happens. And on many places in Plume, at access time, it's database access time, at accessing views, accessing methods, the permissions are checked. So if you call or if you view a page, then several permission checks are done. It slows down Plume a bit, but makes it very secure.
Now let's have a look into Plume. In Plume, in the control panel, we have the users section, and in here we can have a look at the users. I created already a user, John, and John has initially only the member role. Here we see the roles: contributor, editor, member, reader, reviewer, site administrator, and so on. And I now make John an editor and a contributor for the whole site. So this is called the global roles I set. John now can edit and create content in the whole site, but he can't publish it. All his content is created in a private state. Now, how are permissions and roles used to publish content? So you need to know that workflows are behind here. Workflows have states, and each state modifies which role has which permission in the context of a content object. The default workflow has a private state, then content is submitted for publication. A reviewer then publishes the content. If you have the reviewer role additionally, you can directly publish content from private. So let's have a look how we can give John the reviewer role only for the events folder. So let's go to the events folder. At the events folder, we have the sharing menu item. I click it and then I get this view, bit similar to the one we saw before. And I can search for John here. And so John is now listed and we can see he has already the add and edit role globally, but not the reviewer role. But oh, be careful. Here at the top we get an info box that we are not adjusting the sharing privilege for the container, but for the default view. So this means that we are on the default view of a container, so this is very special, but we need to click this Go Here link to go to the container. And then we have to do the same, search for John. And now we are on the container. And this means if I now give him the can review permission, he can review all items in the container and all sub items and so on and so on. If I would have done this for the default view, he would only be able to modify the default view, but nothing in the container. Okay, I save this, and now John can review items in the events folder. Now let's see if John can publish events. In this events folder, there are no events now. I add new event. I call it World Plone Day and set it to the 28th. And that's enough for now. So as an administrator, I have in this state menu all transitions available. Publish and submit for publication. We want to show that John can publish it as well, and as an administrator anyway we submit it for publication. Then in another window I log in as John, and in the next step I go to this event and let's have a look what the state is. It's state pending and John can now publish it. Let's have a look what happens behind the scenes. So we use the management interface and shortly have a look at our event. We can go to our event in the management interface and use the security tab to see the metrics of permissions and roles set on this specific item. Remember, workflow is used to modify this. Never modify the permissions here manually. Otherwise, if a workflow transition happens, you can really destroy your settings. For example, the view permission here is set for anonymous. That means the role anonymous has a view permission and all anonymous users can view this content. This happened after publication. Remember, if I logged in here as John and if I retract this item to private, then we are on the state private. And if I reload this manage access page, I can see that the view permission is no longer available for anonymous, but set for contributor, editor, manager, and so on. Anonymous is available for all, even for the authenticated users. That's how workflow works. Also, this view is very useful if you want to inspect which roles and permissions a user has. If I type in the username here, I can have a look at the permissions set on these items for the specific user and see which roles the user has, which allowed permissions and which permissions are not allowed. The permissions themselves are reduced here. It's only the permissions that are set in this content. All other permissions are acquired. That's it for now. My next talk is then about the pluggable authentication service. Thanks for watching.